Steve Dotto here. Today we are going to talk social media dashboards, specifically HootSuite. Now, what is a social media dashboard? Well, we all now have multiple social media accounts. We've got a Facebook account, a LinkedIn account, a Google Plus account, a Twitter account. We have all of these different accounts, and we need to stay up, or we want to stay up to date on what's happening in each of them. We need to post to them, and we also need to consume information from them. So it's a very time-consuming process going from, say, my Facebook page through to my LinkedIn page and see what people are saying, see what messages are coming through. Let's go on Twitter, see exactly what's happening. Maybe I'm going to post something in Twitter. It becomes a real... It has a pretty negative impact on our productivity. And I don't think that our desire to consume information from all of these different social media sites is on the decline in any way, shape, or form. So we need a better way to manage all of those networks, at least the communication flow coming in and out. That is where a social media dashboard like HootSuite comes in. Now, you should know, HootSuite is not Twitter. It's not just a way to deal with Twitter. It's a way to manage all of our social media assets. And so Twitter may come, it may go. A tool like HootSuite can live well beyond because we integrate it with other aspects of our social media life. I'm going to show you three things in this demo today. The first thing I'm going to show you is how to basically set up your different accounts so that you can access your different social media accounts within HootSuite. Then I'll show you how we consume information in HootSuite, how we follow and track the content that flows in, be they tweets, be they Facebook status updates, how we track all the information coming in and manage it in a really good way. And finally, I'll show you how we share information, how we tweet back out or post back out using HootSuite so we don't have to go into each of those applications independently. And so let's begin with starting HootSuite. The way you sign up, HootSuite is free. There is premium versions, which I'll explain to you where the thresholds are for the premium versions a little bit later. But you just basically go to hootsuite.com, you sign up for an account using one of your social media accounts, and it then creates the account for you. As soon as you've created the account, it will open then in your web browser, regardless of what platform you're on or what web browser you're using. And through the web browser is the best way to manage your HootSuite account. Having said that, once you've set up your HootSuite account, you can then download the app to your iPhone, to your Android phone, to your iPad or other tablet, and you can access HootSuite and use all of the HootSuite tools from all of those mobility applications. In fact, I think that those applications would make a great subject for some future demo, and so I'll make a note to myself to do that. Once you set it up, then you need to start connecting all of your different social media assets. And you can see my account here. Now, my account's mature. I've already set it up. So yours won't look exactly like this when you start. It'll be much more Spartan. And some people have vastly more complicated than mine. But the way we begin is just by going into our account. I'm going to click on Steve Dotto here. And this is where I link HootSuite to all of my different social media accounts. And you can see along in the icons along the top or here, that I have it connected with four different accounts. Now, in the free version, you can hook HootSuite up with up to five of your different social media accounts. And then if you want to connect it with more social media accounts beyond that, it costs $10 a month. And that kind of gets into the more business versions of HootSuite. But for now, I've got mine set up with my Twitter account, with my Dotto Tech Facebook account, which is my Facebook account for my radio show and for these videos, for my personal Facebook page, and for my personal LinkedIn page. Those are the social media sites that I use the most, and so those are the ones that I'm managing through HootSuite. But you know what's growing in my world is Google+. So I need to add Google+ as a social media network here. And all we do, and this is how you add all of yours at the beginning, is click on Add Social Media Network, and up pops a dialog box telling me exactly which social media networks I can sign on with. Now, if something new comes along in another couple of weeks and there becomes a very popular new social media platform, you can rest assured that HootSuite will be integrating it and it will appear here as a selection as the social media universe expands. For now, Google+. I'm going to add my Google+ account. And here, sometimes it seems a little bit voodoo. You'll often be asked to enter your account information. In this particular case, because I'm already signed in with Google+ on some other in some other areas, it actually will find my Google+ account for me, and it'll first of all, tell me exactly what it's going to do, which is important for me to know exactly how it's going to interact with my Google Plus account. I decide to give it access, and then I have my Google Plus account available as one of my social media networks. It's really that easy to incorporate it and to add it as to add different social media assets. Once you have your account set up, it's time to start using HootSuite. And we basically use it to monitor all of the different information flowing into our social media accounts and to send information from those accounts. Those are the main purposes of HootSuite. So here, when we go into our home screen, we see our social media dashboard in action. Now, yours won't look exactly like mine because it'll be just set up in a generic format. We add structure to the social media dashboard right within this screen. So I've got mine set up mainly for Twitter, and I follow, here's my home feed. These are all the different accounts that I'm following on Twitter, and I can read the tweets as they come in, and I can stay up to date on what's happening in the Twittersphere. Next to that are all the mentions. It's a good practice to find out if people are mentioning you in the @Dottotech convention. So if anybody posts anything with @Dottotech, I know about it and I can respond to it, or I'm at least aware that people are talking about me. I like to follow the world of education, so I have an education stream here where I'm following a series of different accounts that are posting interesting information about education. Now, how we create our lists is really quite simple. We can start by adding a stream by clicking over here, but once we've added a stream, we can manage who exactly we follow by going into the preferences for that individual stream, and I'll show you that before we add a stream. This is my education stream, and these are all the people who I really like what they have to say about the world of education, and I follow. If somebody stops saying interesting things, I can uncheck them here so I don't follow them anymore, and I can, of course, most importantly, add new users so that I can follow new people on my stream as I discover new interesting sources of information in the world of education. Now, because this handles so much more than just Twitter, we need to be able to organize it more than just on a single screen, or we'd have a massive screen for all of our different social media accounts. They do this through a tabbed interface. So I've got this home tab set up with the things that I look at the most, which is basically the home feed mentions and the education world. I also have a direct messages tab. If people are sending me direct messages and using Twitter as a communications tool, as a person-to-person communications tool, here's where this is kind of like my email inbox for Twitter. I also have a tab here for LinkedIn. Now, if I had to go back and forth and launch the web browser and move through my and basically launch LinkedIn each time, that would be more time-consuming than having it all here integrated right within HootSuite. So here's all of my different feeds within LinkedIn. Now, this is just the way that I've chosen to organize my HootSuite interface. Some people might like the way that I do it. Other people might say, "Oh, I've got a way more efficient method and I can figure out a way better way of doing it." That's great. It's a personal preference on how you structure HootSuite, but it's flexible enough to allow you to manage the flow of information any way you want. When it comes time for you to add a new stream, if you wanted to add a whole new stream, you simply click Add Stream. You choose what account it's based on, and then you can start to build that stream out. And it will appear as a stream, and then you can move it around. You can put it into whatever tab you want. You have total control over it. The last thing I have time to show you today is how we post information, how we use HootSuite to post into all of our different social media accounts. And there's basically two ways of posting using HootSuite. We can create an original message, or we can reply to an existing message. So here I've got an existing message that I might decide that I want to do something with. I might want to retweet this, in which case I just click here on the retweet button, and then I have the option to retweet this post. I also have the opportunity to reply to it, to direct message from it. Now, you should know that with direct message, you have to be following the person and have them following you in order to send a direct message. We can also send this to email, and we have a few other options here as well. But for the most part, we're going to usually either reply or retweet existing posts. If I retweet it and click on it, the post is then copied in the standard retweet convention. But here's something unique that you wouldn't have if you were just, say, in your Twitter client. I can take this post and not just retweet it here in my Twitter account, but I can retweet it in my Dottotech Facebook account or my personal Facebook account, in my new Google Plus account, or on my LinkedIn account, or all of them. So I have the option to take the information that I think it's important to share and then share it in the appropriate social network of my choice. So that gives us some really nice additional options. If you are, the other thing that I really like about this is actually creating new posts from scratch. So if we were going to start and create a brand new post, I'm going to write in, I want an iPhone. Actually, I don't want to say that. What am I going to write in? I know what I'm going to say. I'm going to ask for a straw poll. Who's using a social media dashboard? Or Ewing. Who is using a social media dashboard? There it is. So, I have a quick question that I want to send out to my social media list. Now, here's a really cool feature. The ability to schedule a post. Now, in a lot of cases, when you're only at your computer for maybe an hour in the morning or 2 hours in the morning when you're thinking about actually sending out tweets and posts, and if you're in corporate communications, you want to be able to kind of batch all of your messages together. But you don't want them all set out in one fast stream, so that you want them kind of metered out through the day. This is the way that I do it with my radio show. On the day that the show airs, I'm tweeting out through the day who the guests are. The next day when I have my podcast up, I tweet out occasionally through the day what stories there are so I can attract people to come and listen to the podcast. I do this all through scheduling, as I create a series of posts and then I schedule the time that they go, and then HootSuite takes over the responsibility of sending them, so I don't have to remember, oh, it's 11:30, I really should send out a tweet about this or that or the other thing. This is a great social media marketing asset within HootSuite. Once you've determined who you're sending it to, when it's being sent, you determine exactly which social media sites you're going to send it to. So I'm going to send it to my Facebook, my LinkedIn, and my Twitter account, and then I'm going to remove scheduling and just send it now. So now it is sent. So that easily now I have sent out a post on all of those sites. Do you want proof? Why not? Let's go to my Facebook page. Let's refresh it. Straw poll. Who's using social media dashboard and which one? What about my LinkedIn account? LinkedIn account. Steve Dotto. Straw poll. And which one? And finally, my Twitter account. Let's take a look at my Twitter feed. Who's using it and which one? HootSuite does far more than I've had time to show you today. It is a complete, almost ecosystem that works for all of your different social media assets. And it will continue to evolve. As new capabilities in the social media world come out, HootSuite will continue to evolve. But this is a great way to look at that. The very first post has come back in, and it's they use HootSuite. Couldn't have set it up better myself. Let's go back into HootSuite, and here are our responses. London Drugs and Courtney, they like HootSuite, as does Gary Ng, iPhone in Canada. That's a pretty solid endorsement, don't you think? I hope you found this demo useful. HootSuite is a tool which will do so much for you. It really gives us an opportunity to kind of mitigate some of the productivity loss that our interest in all of these social networks creates. By using HootSuite, we can recapture a lot of the efficiency that we lose by being engaged in so many social networks. Hey, if you'd like, why not follow me? I'm at Dottotech on Twitter. You can, of course, subscribe to these videos, and you can visit us anytime at dottotech.com. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for spending time with me today.